Welcome to another Magic the Gathering Arena look at a deck, and this particular deck that we're going to look at is Boros Assault. I'm Lostwolfe, and we're going to play a couple of decks with this game, just so you can see how it works. Boros Assault is very much about exerting things, so, like, this is the one card that doesn't do that, but most of the others do. You may exert Glory-bound initiative as it attacks. When you do, it gains +1/+3, so it becomes a 4/4. And has lifelink until end of turn. Now, exert is a mechanism whereby you say, okay, this guy's working extra hard, so he does not untap the next turn. But because he's doing that, he gets bonus stuff. And then most of the rest of these are very much like that. There's nothing I am excited about in this deck at all. The lightning strike excites me a little bit, because I have long-term plans with Lightning Strike itself. But otherwise, it's just a bunch of white-red stuff. This is not my favorite color pairing, so we'll see how it goes. I'm bad at playing decks like this. As you've seen, I'm bad at playing decks, period. But there we go, we got like Ixalan's Binding, which, again, I'm not crazy about because it exiles something but leaves Ixalan's Binding on the table. So they can, in the current version of the game, they can use Naturalize or something like it to get rid of it. And I'm just not crazy about it. But anyway, so let's see what happens when we play this. Play. We're going to select Boros Assault. I'm going to make the obvious pun because I want to get it out the way. The deck should have been called Boros Assault. Ah, that was terrible. Oh boy, this guy's going to have a much better deck than we are. Let's see what happens. This is an okay hand. It doesn't have much, but it has lands and a creature I can play. Well, that's never happened before. I mean, it hasn't happened before when we're playing. We'll claim that and we'll try again. You're going to get a bonus extra match here. Oh, goodness. We didn't see the deck actually work. Why is it taking me here? I definitely want to play with Boros Assault. Okay, I was afraid of that match because he had a much better rank than we did. This guy has a slightly better rank than we do, which means this is going to be awkward. He's going to stomp all over us, probably. That's infinitely worse. Look at this, all white and all red. They are going first. Well, that means we get a draw, so we'll keep this. That can stay at the top. Okay. He is playing a red, which probably means that he's playing burn. So we need to make something terrible first. What do we make first? Well, probably Dauntless Aven. Yeah, Dauntless Aven seems about right. It looks to me like he's playing dinosaurs. In which case, we can pack it up and go home. This deck is not going to be able to cope with dinosaurs. There are a couple of cards that help a little bit, but most of them are just like, oh well. You're going to die now, it's going to be fun. Dinosaurs is very much about getting going quickly. If we can get going quickly, then you're okay. We'll end the turn. I don't want that to die immediately, the minute it comes down. What we are going to do is make the flying man. Sure. Okay, that is very bad. We can let that resolve. But I'm gonna kill that. This is part of the plan that makes it go so fast because he gets to add any color of mana. So I want him to combat. And then at the end of his turn, when he can't really do anything exciting, we'll kill that. So we slow him down. Okay, let's make our dude, which is probably a dead man walking. The thing is, you really want to keep him off of his mana guys and his haste guys, because, and this deck doesn't have enough to protect against that, because otherwise what happens is he just slams down dinosaur after dinosaur and you die. So, if we can slow him down in any significant way, we should definitely do that. Oh, that's a bit frightening. That costs three, right? No, it costs four. Okay. He is very close. Now, you see, he would have been ahead by one turn because he would have been able to make that. And that is not good at all. So, combat. I'm gonna untap this. Not because I'm gonna use it to block, mind you. This is a sorcery. We'll make the other flying man. If he shoots anything, I want it to be one of these things. The problem is, yeah, he's gonna play this now because it deals one damage to any target. So he's just gonna blat my dude. Oh, interesting. Which dinosaur is he going to go after? This lets him search up dinosaurs, and then when he plays them, it does one damage to, I think it's everything. Yeah, one damage to everything. And this has all upside for him because of his enrage and so on. I have no blockers. I wonder if. See, the problem now is I do want to kill this because it's going to be trouble in the long game. But I don't want to kill it because there's worse stuff behind it. Oh well. Hang on now. Cancel? That's five. This is going to cost four. Oh, there isn't anything we can do about that, sure. And let's continue to hit him. That's terrible, but there isn't really a lot else we can do about it. You can untap yourself. You can untap yourself. And that way we have blockers. When this comes down. Oh, right. That's going to deal one damage to everyone anyway. But again, this is all upside for him. Okay, ew. So I wonder. Sure, I'll take it. No blockers. I can do. Okay, so my choices are I can get rid of that. That costs five. That costs four. I can get rid of that, or I can attack. That would be eight. It doesn't get him dead, though. Let's get this off of the board. And we shall carry on attacking. You. you. Hopefully he didn't draw land. Ah, alas, he drew land. No, he didn't draw land. He drew a scary guy. Have no buffers. What does that do? Double strike and eternalize. I should do 1, 2. We should make this. Oh, I misread it. Oh, goodness. Well, that's okay. Because what I really want to do is not have him kill this yet, anyway. Wall attack. Because now, maybe. Although he is going to attack, and that is a problem. He's going to kill one of these. Because that makes the most sense. He can put this down, and it wipes most of my team. Then he attacks. Yeah, we're basically dead here. Then he attacks and kills the rest of my team. Let's fly. No. Okay. Yeah. So I have a choice here. Either I can block, or I can leave this up for the next turn and block that. I think it behooves me to kill this, actually. You have ascend. We're not going to make it to ascend in time. Okay. I was making sure that he didn't pass that ability along, because that would have been awkward. So I'm going to let him, if he attacks here, I'm going to let him through for 8. Which is a bit frightening, but hopefully he'll let me through for 4. Sure. That was what I was hoping for. Don't have anything post-combat, please. Haha. Oh, he doesn't have anything post-combat. That's interesting. That would have been so good. Oh, well. Let's make it. I am almost willing to bet he has fire, yeah. Which is why he's not real concerned with me doing 4 to him. Let's attack. He is probably going to kill Eternalized Friend. And in fact, I should not have put Eternalized Friend down. Yep. Tell me about you. Yeah, okay, that's pretty good. Nice going. Well done. What do we do? I think I need to block the 3-4. Yeah, I do need to block. Well, I need to block everything and I can't. So I'm just dead here. Yep, there we go. That's the problem with dinosaurs. I'm just gonna let him through. When dinosaurs gets going, it just wrecks you. Yeah, sure, of course. I have no blockers. I just want this to happen quickly. Very good. Okay. Try it again. This is why I'm not overly fond of making creatures and winning that way. There are a couple of creatures I like, but they're all control-based creatures. This is not control to me. This is just ramming guys into guys, and if you have better math skills, you win. For some people, that's okay. People like that. That's cool. I'm just not one of those people. This feels like an alright hand. Hey, you have black, which means things that kill non-merfolky guys. Okay. We shall attack before we do anything else. He is playing probably the best sort of medium control you can do in this format, which is either you can do counter spells, or you can do burn. And he's probably playing some amount of creature kill and some amount of burn. Oh goodness, hang on. Cancel attackers. So this is a thing we haven't seen before. You can hit that to exert, or you can hit that to a normal attack. We're going to exert this, because I want to do slightly more damage. And, I guess we'll make you. Now there's a slight trick here where I can put this down, and I'll do that, in fact, once I get a third mana. We'll put this down, and then we can untap that guy. But I think we are basically dead in the water here. Yep. Sounds good. Let's make you. Because he's at 4 mana, which for most of these decks is the magic number for control. Oh goodness, he's playing 5 colors? Maybe? I might be interested in what he's doing here. I have no blockers. This might be interesting. Ah, okay. He wanted to wipe the board, sure. Let's do this. And we shall attack. At some point, he is going to want to get card advantage back. I like this so far. What I've seen of it so far, I like. Oh wow, he really is. No, okay. I thought for a minute there that would be white, but it isn't. Okay, let's do that. We can't eternalize quite yet. How much is eternalize? Oh, looks like it's 5. The eternalized costs are somewhat nuts, I think. Yeah. Sure. So far I like what he's doing, and I'm very curious to see whether or not he plays a 5th land. In other words, a white land. Okay, what are you doing? Sure, you are going for trying to figure out what your next card is. I'm okay with that. Uh, I can't tell if that's a threat or not. I'm gonna go with it kind of is. So we will kill it. And then we'll eternalize. He knows this card exists, so either he stops the eternalize or he doesn't. Sure, he's gonna draw. Right. Oh, that's why it's a turn. Oh, okay. I thought eternalize just gave you the same guy back, but he was a 1/1. Doesn't look like it always does that. Yeah, that's good. Card advantage, friend. I'm gonna sit. I should not be sitting, because he is gaining cards slowly but surely. But I want to see what he's doing. Sure. He is probably going to take the Excellence Binding or the Baffling End. I would take the Excellence Binding. Resolve. Yep, that seems about right. Now he knows about our plan, so he's not really likely to play a creature unless he can also back the creature up. Okay. Sure. Although that's probably just plain dead. They're gonna get to his turn and he's going to smear it all over the floor. Teehee. He is making something a bit scary. Okay, so he's playing the Scarab God, and I don't really have an adequately good response to that. So, what I'm gonna try and do here, we'll give him some damage, which is probably okay, and then this is probably not going to be okay. I need to exile it in order for this to work. But I think he's going to have counter magic. So I don't think this plan is going to adequately stack up. Yep, he wanted it in his graveyard. So he puts it into his graveyard, he gets it back. Smart man. Okay. Oh, goodness. Hold on. Cancel the attack. Do I need to worry about his exert? No. We will just attack. Okay. I think okay, we can cast out. That's what we're going to do. And again, I feel like he probably has counter magic, or he has a way of coping with it. So, let's see what happens. We'll get him to combat. And at the end of his turn, we'll try and cast it out. I need it to get exiled in some way. because otherwise it's just a monster I can't cope with. Okay. Yep. Okay. So that's all right because we got rid of it. Let's baffling end this guy. Oh, baffling end doesn't do anything because he's a 4/4, of course. We shall exert you, and you can't block. Yeah. That baffling end was silly. Okay. We shall do this. And make a land. Now he knows what we have. This guy's probably a dead man walking. I like this less now that I know that he's playing with Scarab Guard, because I feel like that's a crutch card in the current standard. Okay, we're gonna make a attack. And we're going to untap that. And I'm gonna make this. I'm pretty sure we're headed for a gold demise here. Because he has played 2 so far. Yeah, I'm going to take 4. Well, okay, he wiped the board, sure. Right. He has much better card solutions than we do. Playing developer created decks. Ah, goodness. Well, to be fair, I mean, I, on the first night of the beta, I made a deck that you've seen. Ah, there we go. Okay. Well, that's good game. There's nothing I can do about that. Unless I draw another excellence binding, which I don't think there is another one. Sure. We are essentially dead. Yeah, pretty much. Well, not really. You had much better card. You have much better card selection than I did. So I'm not really sure I can call it a good game. But I'm glad your plan worked out. Hooray. I am now much less impressed with this deck. Sorry. I might have given you a false impression of it. I'm much less impressed with it now that I know that he's playing Scarab Guards. Because I feel like that's a pretty much a clutch card in the standard environment. I started talking about that. It basically, there's almost no upside to it unless you can... there's almost no downside to it unless the opponent can exile it. If you can resolve it and you can start pulling stuff from your graveyard, you've basically won. And so... I understand that a lot of people are going to run it, but it just seems like a kind of a bland way to approach standard. What? Well, that was confusing. I'll take it, though. We got a common. Yay! No, that was... Unburdened doesn't look like a common. Claim. Let's get rid of this guy. And tomorrow, when I see you, we'll be playing Azorius Ascension. Which... is a deck... based around Ascend that doesn't have Ascend. but we'll talk about that tomorrow. Thank you so much for watching. As I was saying, I'm your host, Lostwolfe. This has been Magic the Gathering Arena's closed beta. The developers gave us some decks. I'm running you through them so you can see them. I hope that you're enjoying that as much as... Oh, goodness. I am enjoying playing them for you. I shall see you all soon. Have a wonderful evening, and good night for now.